On page 45 in the MISHNA Berura, it's Kotten Gimel. That's the fourth line of the MISHNA Berura. Bahem, that's right. Misha Ta'ava Ocha Bahem. Someone who made a mistake and he ate on one of the fast. The Kombokum Tokal Hashlim Atanis Akasha Ocha. He should fast after, even though he's already eaten. If he suddenly remembers in the middle of the fast that it's the fast day today, he didn't realize, and he should fast. The Misha Ochal Shum Yastav Yuchal Shum, if someone ate garlic, he's got bad breath, he should eat more. It's not going to make it any better, right? If he started eating and he realizes it's a tana, he should fast the rest of the day. Okay. What? It's an expression. It's an expression. If someone's already eating garlic, then he should eat more garlic. He's already got bad breath. It's not going to help if he eats more, it would get even worse. An expression. Okay. Let's see the Shulchan Aruch. Back to Shulchan Aruch this base. Acha gav dichtiv bikro b'chodesh harvi'i b'tisha l'chodesh hudkir ha'ir einis man mis'anin b'teh. Says in the Pasuk that the wall of Yerushalayim was breached on the ninth of Tammuz, the ninth day of the fourth month, which is the ninth of Tammuz. Ein mis'anin b'teh. Even so, we do not fast on the ninth. Elu b'zayin, we fast on the 17th. Why? B'vnei she'af ha'fisha b'rishoyno hudkir b'teh boy. Kim Shabashnia, Huvka O, Yud Zayin Boy, Tiknu Lithanus Yud Zayin Boy. Even though the Pasuk is talking about the first Beit HaMikdash, right? Tanakh is talking about the first Beit HaMikdash. First Beit HaMikdash, the wall was breached on the 9th of Tammuz. And in the second Beit HaMikdash, it was breached on the 17th of Tammuz. And therefore, we fast on Shiva Otto B'Tammuz, which is that the wall of the second Beit HaMikdash was breached. Why is this? Mishum dechul b'mayi sheni chomolam, because the destruction of the second Beit HaMikdash is worse for us, because the first Beit HaMikdash was rebuilt. The second one hasn't yet been rebuilt. We're suffering now because of the chulban of the second Beit HaMikdash, and therefore we fast on the 17th, which is the day when the wall was breached for the second Beit HaMikdash. The Mishavot of Kodim Dalet says, V'loi rotu ligdo gam betes, te'im machich nad alat ha'b'yotu medai. The Chazal weren't go there that we should fast also on the 9th. Why not fast on both of them? Why just pick one or the other? Why not fast on both? The Chazal didn't want to be go there also on the 9th, because that's putting too much tilcha on the tibble. To expect the tibble to fast on the 9th and on the 17th was too much. So the Chazal decided just to pick one of them, to pick the 17th, because that's when the second base of Mikdash, the wall of the second base of Mikdash was breached. As in the wall of Yerushalayim. Between the time of the second base of Midrash is breached. So we fast on Yuzayim, the time of Midrash is back. Okay. And that's the end of the philosophical test. Our locus is full training. Right? And there's obviously, we mentioned, we've been talking about full training. We haven't talked about Tanis Esther and Yom Kippur, because they're completely different fasts. The four we're talking about are the four that are connected to the Chulban Beis HaMikdash. Okay, let's move on to Simon Tovkuf Nun, the next Simon.
What's the line said?
And Yom Kippur. Yom Kippur's deraita is about doing teshuvah. And the Tanis Esther, which is more of a happy fast than a sad fast. Tanis Esther is about how if we have Torah and we daven Hashem, Hashem answers us. Whereas these four fasts are all about Avelus. They're some connected to Avelus there. It all led to the destruction of the Beit HaMikdash. So the Tosk of Nun Hevdol Sheyesh Bein Tisha B'Av L'Yefel Tohime. Sif Al. Hakol Chayovim Nis'anus Ar Batoimus Halolu V'Oslo Lifroi Gede. Everyone is Chayev Tafah Lifah, and one may not be put together. One may not, it literally means to break down a wall, to put together. It means that he's a going against what Chazal were goyze, what the Nevi'im were goyze. Everyone has to fast. Hago, Tazuma, Mihu, Uvrois Umeyikois. However, pregnant women and nursing women, that they, it's very difficult for them to fast, they have pain. Aimless Amnes, they don't need to fast. Vafilu Einon Mitzarois, Einon Mechuyovos is Amnes. Even if they have pain, they don't have to fast at all. Even if they haven't, if they're not in pain, they don't have to fast. Elishin Nohagul Hachme, however they are Noyeg, their Minhag was to fast. They decided to fast themselves. Kedafke Begimul Tzaymis, this is only referring to the three fasts, that they don't need to fast. Aber Tisha B'Av Mechuyoveis Lashim. On Tisha B'Av, then they do need to fast. So let's have a look at the Mishna Berura. Let's see, Mishna Berura says cotton base. Mishna Berura says cotton base. Move the first white line. The Bishol Shavot to the Kibla Alein is Anis Kilu Lechat Chil Alein. When Kalifa Mekabelon was of the fast, they were making on the Mubaris and Menitis, the nursing women and the pregnant women. Mishabus upon Gimel, Ubris and Menitis, and Mistabu, the Ubris, Mikri, Mishasha, Hukar of Lad, Kidakamlon and Investors. And Uber, and a pregnant woman is defined as when it's recognizable that she's pregnant. And Mikomokum Eshad, Afidu, the Achar, Boim, Yim, Litis, have Lad, Nami, have a Levicham Uberis. Could be even 40 days after the fertilization, after the blood starts being created, it could be that's already defined as a pregnant woman in there. In my guess, if she feels pain. Less than this, she's like any other woman, unless she has lots of pain. And if she feels weakness, then she shouldn't fast at all. So it says here that pregnant women and nursing women fast like anyone else, unless they have a lot of pain. Now the in Eretz Yisrael, Rabbonim are much more mekil for pregnant women. It's probably because of the heat. It's very, very hot at this time of year, and therefore generally, I mean, everyone should ask their own child as well. But very often, Rabbonim are more mekel that tell pregnant women and nursing women not to fast at all. In our service, there are many of them also mekel in that. Yeah. The question is why that is the case. There are many that are mekel for that as well. Yeah. If cotton dalad. And certainly a choyle, someone who's ill, even if it's a sort of ill, even if there's no sakona, there's no danger associated with fasting. It's not going to put him in any life-threatening situation. But he's ill, he has fever, he's ill, he's potom in his anus, he's potom fasting, but also he shouldn't be machman himself, he's potom. Obviously, in every case of illness, one should ask a rov to make sure that we're not talking about this stun, that someone's not feeling so good that day, we're talking about that he's probably ill. Should ask a shayla. If they're weak, this is the Ramah. This is the Ramah talking about the Ramah who says that pregnant women and nursing women do fast. Which many are known like this. Even if they are weak, then they shouldn't be machm. If they're feeling weak, then they should break their fast. The mekomokim afatorich daechoin lo yis anigat me b'vosav yanigat kafiyat mashetorich. However, even someone who is not fasting, he's ill, and he's not fasting, he should not eat meat, and he shouldn't be misanig. He shouldn't eat enjoyable things, meat. And why? He should just eat the minimum, what he needs to eat in order to keep him healthy. He shouldn't indulge. Ketanim, And even, we're not mechuyev to be mechanech them, even if they're 12 years old, we're talking about a boy, right? A girl already at 12 is a gedolah, she has to fast already from 12. A boy only has to fast from 13. So, However, these ketanim, a boy less than 13, a girl less than 12, it is correct to be mechanech them that they shouldn't. They should only eat what they need to eat. Lechem and mayim, bread and water, oishama, apoposhot, or other simple foods. So that they join in with the mourning of the tibur. They should eat just the basics. We're talking here about older children, right? It's just before the mitzvah. Where they understand. Sheish lem da'at l'savah, where they understand what it means to mourn. Maybe age 10, 11, that sort of thing. If they, thanks to Shavnach, if they. So in this halal luchus mitzvah av, mitzvah berchitza, v'sicha, v'neila safanzen, v'tashmish hamitza. These fasts, besides Tisha B'Av, one can wash, anoint oneself, wear leather shoes, and have marital relations, v'im tach v'asik v'hem mi'v'idyoim, and one does not need to stop eating before shkia, meaning the fast does not start at night. The fast only starts in the morning at Eilat HaShachar. Tisha B'Av starts at night, meaning one lahafstik, one stops eating while it's still day, because the fast starts already at night at Shkia, whereas the other fast only starts in the morning at Aloy Tashacha, at daybreak, and therefore one stops eating, and one can eat at night. Okay, it means to put on creams and things. Creams. What's a cologne? Cologne is aftershave. I think cologne would be included. Do you think it's not included? I think it's good. Deodorant, my Rosh Kalim of Berkeley talks about deodorant. And he said deodorant is defined as a sicha she'im botanic. It's a sicha, called sicha, but it's not for enjoyment. So we're going to see that there's a difference. We'll get to it. We're going to see there's a difference between Yom Kippur and Tisha B'Av with this. We'll see when we get to it. We'll see that later. Right. That's a good question. Let me think about it. When we get to halacha of the season, we'll think about it. Let me think about it. Okay. Let's have a look at the Mishna versus Kosher Vav. And the majority of the community couldn't stand by such a tough gezeira that all the fasts would be as strict as the fast of Tisha B'Av, and therefore they made the other three fasts more lenient than Tisha B'Av. A Baal Nefesh, someone who's a Machme should be Machme, the Kulon come over Tisha B'Av. Should pass on all of them, like Tisha B'Av. We Machme all the five things, and stop eating by night. Elo She'im Chol Leil Leil Tvila. You can't mean also, if it's a night of Tvila, then he should be Mekayim his mitzvah. V'gam B'Ila Safandel Lo Yachme Mishum Chucha Tlula. Also, he should not be Machme with not wearing leather shoes. Because it's very noticeable, people will notice it. V'chein im chol yud b'tevis b'erev Shabbos ein lehachme b'chitza b'chamin. And if asor b'tevis falls on erev Shabbos, one should not be machme with b'chitza b'chamin. Meaning one should wash with hot water, even someone who's machme. If not with Shabbos, because of Shabbos, he should wash with hot water. Now he mentions in the Sharat Tzion, it's gotten ches. He writes, "V'ayin ba'ateh zov shekotav da'achshav einog nirchos begumotayim ois." The minhag nowadays is not to wash on the three fast. The chosav b'vim godim d'hainu b'chamin. The b'vim godim says that's talking about with hot water. Aber b'tzoyning yesh lo ima d'shovi begumotayim ois v'adin ponav yot v'rak l'b'chamin yesh ima d'shovi. But one may wash with cold water during the three fast. We're talking about not the other fast. One may wash with cold water, and one may wash one's hands, feet, and legs with hot water. So one shouldn't have hot showers on the three fast. Right? Meaning we're noyeg not to. It means we're noyeg not to have hot showers. Okay. And let's move on. It's called Zion. And the angel of the column is by James, Kamoi Betishabav, and the Musa Ben Bachid Oshir Balaina. There is one may eat and drink by night. Except his. Sorry. One may eat and drink by night except Tishabav. Okay. Sif Gimel. If you call dalat famous halalu, im cholu lihiyos Shabbos nidchin la'achar Shabbos. All these four fasts, if they fell on Shabbos, they're pushed over to after Shabbos, so to Sunday, which is what happened just now with Shivos V'Tamuz, and it's going to happen with Tisha B'Av in a week and a half. If it falls on Shabbos, it's pushed over to after Shabbos. Agav im cholu be'erev Shabbos, chorim b'shachar, if it fell on erev Shabbos. Which is only possible with Atar B'Tevis, the way the calendar has been fixed nowadays, only Atar B'Tevis has been fallen out of Shabbos. They fall on Erev Shabbos. Koyim b'Shachris and Mincha Vayechal. We do read on Shachris and Mincha Vayechal. Even though it's Erev Shabbos, we read Mincha Vayechal. We mentioned yesterday the reason why we fast, the main purpose is for us to start doing Teshuvah, to cause us to do Teshuvah. As it says, we say also with the prophet with the ninve, it says that Vayar Elokimus is Maaseihem, Hashem saw their deeds. The sackcloth and fast is supposed to lead us to do Teshuvah. That's the reason for the laning. The laning of Vayachar. Right? As we ask Hashem, Shuv Mechar and Apecho, and we mention the Yud Gimel Mitzvah, Hashem Hashem Kerach and Mechanon, which is what we say during Slichas, or we think during Elul. It's all about doing Teshuvah. And also the Haftorah that we say in Mincha. Tirushu Hashem bin Motzoi. Seek Hashem when he's close to Ra'uha B'yot Sekovos. Seek him when he's close. It's all about doing Teshuvah. The laning and the Haftorah is this theme of doing Teshuvah. So even if it falls on Erev Shabbos, we read Vayechal in Mincha. V'meish Chupa B'yom Matanis Erev Shabbos. Ve'agim Nifal in Mincha V'likos Vayechal V'achar Kachos in HaChupa. If there's a Chupa on the day of the fast, on Erev Shabbos, then it's done, then the Chupa takes place after Mincha and Vayechal. Let's do the Mishna Berura. Yeah, in Eretz Yisrael, in Echos Eretz it's unheard of. In Eretz Yisrael it's more common because this is their day off. In the olden days they used to do it. They always used to do it on Shabbos because they were very poor and they didn't have money. So they did it on Erev Shabbos just before night, and then the Suda Shabbos, they anyway had to have Suda Shabbos. So the Suda Shabbos was the Suda Nisuin, they didn't have to make an extra Suda. A couple of minutes. Mishbos has gotten. Ches kol dalat shemus kol lav daskel deloylo mein asar betev ein asar betev ischar b'shabbos asar betev is never falls on Shabbos. It's called says nitzchin achar Shabbos v'lo yikodim back to move forward for an Israel making minna. The reason why we push off the fast to Sunday and we don't bring it forward is because we don't want to bring a pur'onus. We don't want to bring a pur'onus forward. We want to push it off. So we rather push them off until the day afterwards. Tainus Esther, we bring it forward. We don't push it, we bring it forward. But Tainus Esther is not a Puranus one. And also, we can't push it off the next day. But it's not like these fasts, which are Venus. It's more of a happy fast than a sad fast. Shabbos, if it turns out to Thursday, Shabbos will be forward to Thursday. It's Kofen Yud, Vimcholi Be'era Shabbos, Ha'ilif Negam Kein Nav Dafka, Zecholat Alev Toim is Gam Kein, Yesh Elochu Be'era Shabbos, if Yakvir Hamuvo Le'ob Zimun, Shabbos Tofos Cheskim, Asob Tevitz Buva, but only as we mentioned, now that the Luach has been fixed, Asob Tevitz is the only fast that can fall on Erev Shabbos. And the question you dalef the shachris and mincha vaychal. Who had in the oimer hashat aneinu ben goyle roife? Even though it's erev Shabbos mincha, the shat does say aneinu as we always do in the fast. He says it between the brachos of goyel and roife. Aval ein oimer vidui mincha yasafayim b'mincha b'fish erev Shabbos. We don't say vidu. We don't say tachnon on erev Shabbos because it's erev Shabbos. Mitam ze ein laf is by erev Shabbos yom kippur cotton. Those who do yom kippur cotton. Before on Erev Rosh Chodesh, one does not do it we don't do it on Erev Shabbos because we can't do Viduyim on Erev Shabbos. Then Rosh Chodesh for Shabbos, Kiyim B'Yom Chamish Shavanos. If Rosh Chodesh falls on Shabbos, Yom Kippur Cotton is brought early to Thursday. If you say Loim Mastichas can be done by Erev Shabbos Mincha because we don't say Stichas and Vidui on Erev Shabbos Mincha. Okay, stop here. We'll go over the time. We'll continue on. Tell me what's the same.